Today is 20th April 2018. This is the Professor Parafinda Sechibofre, the senior grammarian, the professor and the total grammarian globally. I have come to teach all world population about the verbs. The topic today is not politics, but is under the umbrella of my politics of 200 good many courses on Rwanda and good many 2000 courses as well on African continent. Verb is a doing word, or is a word that shows an action. A verb has two major parts, regular verbs, two irregular verbs. Total explanation is on each type of a verb. Regular verbs also have two main parts, A or part A. Those verbs do have ED ending in past tense. Supply examples here. In infinitive verb and in past tense. To answer, its past tense is answered. To woo, wooed. Civilize, civilized. Demand, demanded. Grab, grabbed. Part 2. To cook, cooked. Look, looked. Dance, danced. Walk, walked. Work, worked. Part B, still on regular verbs, those verbs do have IED ending in their past tense. Let us here supply good examples in infinitive and in their past tense. To cry, cried. To try, tried. To carry, carried. To worry, worried. To hurry, hurried. To bury, buried. To fry, fried. To deny, denied. To dry, dried. To marry, married. To irregular verbs. Irregular verbs are also divided into three main major parts. Part 1 on irregular verbs. Those verbs do change a middle vowel in their past tense. Let us also supply examples here in infinitive and in their past tense. To come, came. To become, became. To give, gave. To forgive, forgave. To get, got. To forget, forgot. To drink, drank. To drive, drove. To run, ran. To sit, sat. Part 2 of irregular verbs. Those verbs do change completely in their past tense. Let us also have good examples here in infinitive and in their past tense. To go, went. To buy, bought. To sell, sold. To fight, fought. To bring, brought. To sweep, swept. To keep, kept. To take, took. To make, made. To think, thought. Part 3 of irregular verbs. Those verbs do not change at all in their past tense. Let us also supply here very many good examples as well in infinitive verbs and in their past tense. To cut, cut. To put. To hit, hit. To hurt, hurt. To beat, beat. To read, read. To shut, shut. To broadcast, broadcast. To cast, cast. To cost, cost. Here, one can go on conjugating these verbs. Conjugation of irregular verbs, first, and regular verbs in the second phase. And they are prefixes or prefixed together. In infinitive verbs, you can show them they must always be having this prefix too. Present continuous tense, that too goes away and gains ing. Sometimes you may call it present continuous tense or present progressive or present participle or gerund. Past participle tense, you may call it a new pattern or present perfect tense, then past tense. Past tense can also be called the previous pattern or habitual tense. Just to mention a few, you can go on conjugating until you conjugate 20,000 good many verbs. To help people to speak and write, think excellently, safe and soundly, soberly, and never to go astray. When you are speaking or writing English, you just speak as your world grammarian, Barafinda Fred, the man on earth with total seniority in grammar. That's where all people hanged and named him the grammarian professor, but I feel the such threat in the whole world. So I have come to teach people how to speak the real grammar using the principles of better spoken and better written globally. Thank you very much indeed.